Hey guys, I'm Anil, and this is Pockit. Pockit is a card-sized modular computer that can be instantly shaped into all kinds of gadgets and inventions by laying out whatever blocks fit exactly your specific application. With today's demo, I'm excited to share what Pockit has grown to in the last few months, including a powerful upgrade I made to the core board, lots of new blocks, a dashboard to command everything, the potential for makers, for edge computing, and for home automation, and some thoughts on how I envision modular electronics can behave. The project has come really far, and in the coming weeks, I plan to finalize the current designs for the PCBs and for molded casings with, of course, a better matte finish than the current 3D prints. The aim now is to produce an initial batch of Pockits and get them into the hands of those who have shown interest. So now, the demo. As usual, let's get started with the basics. The Pockit core board provides an interactive, magnetic workspace to quickly create devices and edit them by experimenting with various blocks. These three are just a Hello World example. The ecosystem already has a large variety of blocks, and the signal grid makes it equally easy to hot plug even the more complex blocks, like this SPI-based display, which quickly yields an app GUI or a behind-the-scenes monitor for the blocks. Through Pockit's interplay of the software modules, we can effortlessly create new combinations in almost all well-defined cases. Hardware-agnostic software, through dynamic switching, allows us, for example, to swap the previous SPI display with a bigger HDMI one. This time with a capacitive touchscreen. With a modularly insertable Pi compute processor, Pockit can even run Linux, which opens up powerful possibilities with some of the blocks. Before those, let's explore the modular foundation. Each block's behavior is represented with class instances in the core microprocessor. But the true magic of modular hardware happens when multiple blocks combine into an application, or even activate a new one.
Hello.
Alexa?
Yes.
Turn on relay one. Alexa?
Yes.
Turn on relay two. Note that the overall device has fluid behavior, subject to the user's taste, specifically depending on the exact hardware combination or software choices. In this sense, the project emphasizes not only hardware-agnostic software, but also software-agnostic hardware. Now let's quickly turn Pockit into a full-blown traditional computer by adding our desired accessories. With the HDMI block connected to a monitor, I'll explore one of my favorite recent additions, the dashboard. Think of the dashboard as the front end, a dynamic cockpit for the board's activities. It's made with JavaScript, Python, and WebSockets, and it can be used as served on Pockit itself, or through a display block, or with any mobile or other device on the same network. The control center area shows an easily programmable tile grid to view and control everything related to our running app, Apps are similar to phone apps, but for hardware. The sidebar contains the block monitor, showing all currently connected blocks, and most importantly, the app selector. Since Pockit is a shapeable device, apps are more like situational skills. An app can be manually selected, or the board auto-loads the best matching app seamlessly as the user adjusts blocks. For this, I implemented an algorithm that scores all apps continuously based on multiple factors. Primarily, the match to current blocks, but also block roles and positions and app usage frequency. So Pockit smoothly transitions to at least boilerplate behaviors for blocks in all cases, and often the exact desired app. Let's take a closer look at an app. This one has some tiles to control a camera and view the camera's output. The modular hardware has analogous software pieces, and apps can adapt their behavior to attached blocks. For instance, a dashboard tile can do a photo capture action, but so can physical blocks. This customizability is especially amplified if a user programs the device's behavior with expected relationships between blocks and any functions. Because attaching blocks augments an app's feature set, the control center updates individual tiles accordingly. And new tiles can also appear based on which blocks are currently active. Notice that changing to a compatible block, like a different camera, allows the device to keep operating with the same app, though differently. Altogether, the apps produce incrementally growing behavior based on the blocks attached, while the dashboard can act as the eyes and hands for whatever is the user's constructed gadget, letting you operate what Pockit sees and does. Mixing and matching the hardware ingredients can create different types of rich sensory interaction with the physical world, all with minimal power consumption. Most use cases, like this one, even with a display block attached, can run on the battery block. Let's really test the limits now of this kind of edge computing. While Pockit's original microcontroller could run a simple camera by itself, adding the Pi Compute quad-core processor gives it state-of-the-art capabilities, such as TensorFlow-based object detection. This inferencing process can work decently even in not-so-ideal conditions. To avoid going outside, let's put a laptop in front of the camera and take a drive into a random YouTube video. A full machine learning and detection pipeline is not bad for a $25 processor chip. But can we do better? Motivated by dozens of comments from community members, I spent the last several months upgrading and testing Pockit's PCB design to work with a CPU that's substantially more powerful. Specifically, the Broadcom BCM2711 that you may know from the Raspberry Pi 4B. So 1.5 GHz at our disposal, Let's take the new version of Pockit for a test drive. With the same 4 processor in place, I'll run the numbers again now. And just like that, we get twice the frame computation speed on the same challenge based on a deep learning neural network. Now, there is a way to make this even faster. Almost 10 times faster. This one's a bit of a trick. This particular block circuitry is based around the Edge TPU, an ASIC chip that was developed by Google to boost machine learning models and can perform 4 trillion operations per second. For this block's current version, I soldered circuitry directly taken from Google's dev board. However, I'm also working on a much smaller accelerator block that uses a Kendrite K210 chip. And also one for a tiny 10x15mm version of the exact same Google TPU. But this will appear in a future video when the chip is actually in stock. Even without a task-specialized block, of course, the newer Broadcom CPU helps Pockit achieve very respectable speeds for complex tasks, such as media pipe pose estimation. And visual tracking. And even stereo depth vision. As a side effect of the recent board upgrade, I decided to also create some special hardware accessories, like this SSD block based on the PCIe interface. While I haven't officially integrated it into the dashboards apps yet, I've already gotten the block working, and it should supply an immense amount of storage for portable and stationary applications alike. All right, next, home automation possibilities. Recently, I wrote a lot of code to marry Pockit's blocks with smart home frameworks. The core board can now run a Home Assistant server and ESP Home as one-click apps. Pockit's internal Wi-Fi, of course, can directly monitor various home appliances. But imagine we want to talk to devices that speak the very common Zigbee protocol, or really anything else. In past videos, I showed RF hardware, such as a LoRa block. This time, a new block based on the Texas Instruments CC2531 can give us Zigbee communication within seconds. Likewise, it's possible to couple basically any Pockit blocks to cards or devices. For instance, a camera block. Since Pockit boards can wirelessly talk to each other, this opens up a whole array of DIY possibilities for devices. For a more fun demonstration, I'll use a half-size Pockit I've been experimenting with. This case does require some very basic ESP Home programming. On one Pockit, I create a button block action. And on our earlier Pockit, I pair this action's event with the light bulb through the Zigbee block. Thus, within minutes, we can create flexible and enjoyable interactions. One of the project's goals has been to make readily deployable gadgets. Here are two simple examples. With all of Pockit's modular computing capabilities, the ceiling is really just the user's creativity. Here's a mix of everything, human-machine interface. For this assembly, I'll also slide in a big capacitive touch display, and I'll use the new screwless method that I've designed recently for side block expansion of Pockit. That's all for now. Go to pockit.ai. I'm taking some early access signups there, and also you can see lots of project details. Thanks for all the support so far, guys. Stay tuned for the next update.